Hello there, my name is McHorse, and welcome to a tutorial video on how to add OBJ models to Blockbuster mod. In this video, I'll show you how to add a static bus model to Blockbuster mod. Before we get started, I'm going to assume that you have Blockbuster 1.4.9 and Metamorph 1.1.4 mods installed, and know the basics of Blender 3D, which is a free open source modeling software. But first, a bit of theory. So how does the OBJ model loading works in Blockbuster? It's quite simple. For every model, in Blockbuster's models folder, Blockbuster looks for a file named model.obj. If that file is found, and custom model allows loading of OBJ models, JSON custom models must explicitly allow OBJ loading. OBJ loader reads all objects from OBJ file, constructs models from supplied data, and substitutes default cubic limbs with an OBJ object matching the same name from OBJ file. So essentially, OBJ loading is a feature in custom models code, which simply substitute limbs with custom geometry. OBJ model can't get loaded without a JSON custom model. Also, it's worth mentioning that OBJ models and default cubic limbs share the same texture, so you need to be aware of your UV mapping. So now once you know everything about the OBJ loading, we're ready to start with OBJ model. If you didn't understand how it works under the hood, don't worry, just follow the steps in the video, and hopefully it will work out. Download the model linked in the description, and unzip it. In the folder we've got thumbnail, OBJ files, 3DS model, and the texture. Don't mind other files, we need only OBJ file and the texture. So before putting those files into Blockbuster's models folder, we need to check whether the model has correct size, position and orientation, and then re-export it with different parameters. Open Blender. Import OBJ model. And look at the following properties of the model. How big is the model relative to the grid? Where is model's origin? Our UV mapping is correct? Is model facing the correct direction? And whether the one object or several? With this bus model, it looks quite good. The bus's center is at the origin. You can tell that by looking at the orange point, and it intercepts all axes. Its scale is quite appropriate. You can tell that by selecting any top vertex, and see the Y value, which is 1.94, which would be about 1.94 blocks high. And if you switch to texture display, the UV coordinates seem to be correctly mapped. However, there are several objects in the scene, and the bus isn't oriented in the correct direction. So, we need to join all objects together into one object, and rotate the model so it will face the positive Y. You can do that by rotating the model around Z axis so it would face same direction as the green arrow. So everything looks good. Good. There is another thing left to be done before exporting. We need to rename the object. This is needed for the limb substitution process. Go to Object tab, and rename the object. Go to Data tab, and rename the data to the same name. Renaming both objects and data to the same name matters, because in the end it's the name which objects gets in the OBJ file. Without both names matching each other, the name will be useless. Now we can export the OBJ model. In the export screen, go to Blockbuster's folder models. Create a new folder, and export the OBJ model as file named model.obj. Make sure that triangulate faces checkbox is checked. It's very important, because otherwise, this will happen. We're almost done. Now we need to create a JSON custom model for that OBJ model. Go to Minecraft, open up the model editor. You have to assign the key to the model editor first. Remove all limbs, for exception of the body limb. Bring the body down below. and, finally, save it. There are few finishing touches left before we could see the boss in the game. Click on the cog icon, and check the checkbox with label provides OBJ model, and save the model again. And finally, drag and drop the texture we found in boss's folder to the custom model's skins folder. If we'll go to creative morph menu, we will see the boss morph appear, and now we can morph into a boss. Well, that's it about adding static OBJ models to Blockbuster mod. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.